What's going on, subway surfers? We're back on the surface today, exploring some of Toronto's lost via rail stations. While via train service two stops at Guildwood and Union Station today, there were previously five other stations throughout the city, with service via trains running across the province and the country. We have visited where these stations used to be to see if any traces remain since their closure, and we'll explore their history as well as what we found. I'm Zach with Vanished Underground, and let's get started. The first station on our list is Agincourt, located along Sheppard Avenue between Kennedy and Midland in Scarborough. Originally serviced by CN commuter trains, the route was taken over by VIA in 1978. One southbound trip was operated on weekday mornings from Stouffville to Union, followed by one northbound trip returning to Stouffville in the afternoon. Travel time from Agincourt to Union was 27 minutes, with the southbound train departing the station at 7:38 on weekdays, and the northbound train arriving at 5:47. Located in the same location as the current GO station, the site was minimal, containing only a simple platform. A station building on the site was closed and demolished near the end of the 1970s. VIA trains serviced the station for only 4 years, until GO Transit took over service in September 1982. With this change, the current station building was constructed, even though the schedule remained the same for many years after GO's takeover. Very little evidence remains at the station of the former VIA service, especially given the station is currently being reconstructed again to add a second track and platform. The next station on our list is also named Agincourt, located along Brimley Road just north of Sheppard in Scarborough. Originally serviced by CP trains, the route was taken over by VIA in 1978. One southbound trip was operated daily from Havelock in Peterborough to Union, followed by one northbound trip returning to Havelock in the afternoon or evening. From the station, travel time to Union was 18 minutes, while travel time to Peterborough was just over an hour and a half. On weekdays, the westbound train departed for Union at 8:20, with an eastbound train returning to Peterborough and Havelock at 5:48. Saturday saw a westbound departure 1 hour later at 9:20, and an eastbound train at the same evening time of 5:48. Sunday service operated later in the day, with the westbound train departing at 7:55 p.m. and returning east to Peterborough and Havelock at 9:48. Service on the line was cancelled in September 1982, with GO Transit opting not to take over the service. In June 1985, service was restored along the line. However, trains did not stop at Agincourt again until 1986 with a slightly revised schedule. Additionally, the GO trains now operating at the nearby Agincourt GO station, local travel along the line between Agincourt and Union was no longer allowed. Service on the line once again ceased in January 1990, along with many other VIA services across the country. While the station building was demolished in 1975, traces of the former station and platforms remain. Staircases on the west side of Brimley Road remain in place, although they are blocked off. While CP freight trains pass by this location frequently, no passenger trains currently run along the tracks in this location. In the future, there are plans for VIA trains to once again pass through this station without stopping, as part of VIA's high-frequency rail plan. Third on our list is Leaside, located near the intersection of Millwood Road and Overlea. Like Agincourt, this station was also originally serviced by CP trains and taken over by VIA in 1978. Running between Havelock, Peterborough, and Union, trains deviated south along the Don Branch after servicing the station, passing over the GO Richmond Hill Line tracks near the Evergreen Brickworks. One round trip serviced the station daily, with travel time to Union being a short 8 minutes. Service on the line was cancelled in September 1982, with GO Transit opting not to take over the service. Service on the line was restored between 1985 and 1990. However, Leaside Station was not reopened. The station building remained standing, however, was heavily renovated in 1975 when it closed to passengers and reopened as a CP-owned restaurant. Unfortunately, the restaurant was closed 1 year after passenger service stopped at the station, and although it saw other uses for a couple years, the station building now sits abandoned. In the future, there are plans for VIA trains to once again pass through the station without stopping, as part of VIA's high-frequency rail plan. Fourth on our list is St. Clair Avenue Station, located near the intersection of St. Clair Avenue and Caledonia. The station was originally served by CN trains and taken over by VIA in 1978. Two main services stopped at the station. The first was a commuter train running on weekdays between Barrie and Toronto, while the second was VIA Rail's transcontinental service to Vancouver. For the commuter service, one southbound trip was operated on weekday mornings from Barrie to Union, followed by one northbound trip returning to Barrie in the afternoon. Travel time from St. Clair Avenue to Union was 15 minutes, with the southbound train departing the station at 8:03 on weekdays, and the northbound train arriving at 5:30. Transcontinental trains consisted of the Supercontinental, stopping once daily at the station in each direction until 1981. Near the end of that year, the Supercontinental was replaced at St. Clair Avenue Station by the Canadian, which followed a different route to Vancouver with one daily trip in each direction. On all trains, local travel from St. Clair to Union was not allowed, as both were serviced by the TTC. Commuter service to Barrie was taken over by GO Transit in September 1982. However, GO opted not to stop at the station. Canadian service continued until 1985, when the stop was removed from the timetable. The station structure remained in place, however, until 1997, when it was unfortunately lost to a fire. Staircases from St. Clair to the platform on the north side of the street, as well as some old pieces of the platform visible from satellite imagery, are all that remain of the station today. Our last stop is at West Toronto Station, located near the intersection of Old Weston Road and Davenport. The station was originally serviced by CN trains, which were taken over by VIA in 1978. At that time, 4 to 5 trains daily stopped at the station in each direction, running between Toronto and London. Travel time from West Toronto to Union was 14 minutes. However, local travel was not allowed between the two stations, as they were both serviced by the TTC. In 1983, service was reduced from 5 to 3 trains in each direction with the opening of Malton, with trains stopping in a skip-stop fashion with the new station. Service was further reduced in 1987, with a singular southbound train at 8:13, 6 days a week, and a northbound trip stopping at 4:43 daily. The station closed to passengers in early 1989, and was demolished near the turn of the century. The area underwent heavy construction in early 2010s as part of the Georgetown South project, which resulted in the CN tracks being grade separated through Old Weston. This construction removed virtually all traces of the former station, with only a vacant plot of land between the CN and CP tracks remaining as testament to the former station site. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new about the history of VIA Rail stations in Toronto. In the coming weeks, we'll be presenting a full evolution of the VIA Rail network from its formation in 1978 until today, which you'll be able to access by clicking the button in the top right corner of your screen. Feel free to leave a like and a comment if you have any questions or want to see more. And as for us here, we'll be Vanishing Underground until the next one.